Nananawagan na ako kay Presidente Duterte, makialam siya. Alam naman niya na walang kasalanan ng aking asawa para patayin.
Erlinda is calling for justice from President Duterte for her slain husband, Anak Pawis Chairman Randy Etchanis, who was killed inside a rented apartment in Quezon City Monday. She also appeals to the Quezon City Police District to return the remains of her husband and allow them to mourn.
Ang pamilya po ang may karapatan do sa bangkay. Ang hindi po namin maintindihan ay bakit hinohold nila yung bangkay, eh patay na yung tao. Kung meron man dapat silang imbestigahan, hindi yung patay.
The family's lawyer argues there is no need for a release order before Etchanis' remains are turned over to his family.
Si Karandi Randall Etchanis ay hindi isang detained person, so hindi siya sa custody ng court, hindi siya nakakulong at wala siya sa custody ng mga PNP. So there is no basis for a release order. Pangalawa, hindi siya namatay sa isang encounter para i-hold nila yung katawan.
The Etchanis family also wants an independent autopsy. According to them, their loved one sustained a gunshot wound on his head and 21 stab wounds in his body. The QCPD, however, said they still need to confirm the identity of the deceased. Cops said an ID recovered from the crime scene showed the victim's identity as a certain Manuel Santiago.
Dahil yun po ang nakita doon sa crime scene na mga ID. Pertaining to Manuel Santiago naman, yun din po ang binanggit ng may-ari ng bahay na pinakilala sa kanya. May probe. Tapos yung probe dito ay dahil hindi po natin siguro kung mas maganda siguro kung may dala silang mga specimen through fingerprints. O kung maaari nga po sana kung kamag-anak, ipa-DNA natin para sigurado tayo.
The lawyer of Etchanis has already submitted pertinent documents to Camp Caringal Tuesday afternoon to prove the identity of the victim. Rachel Pastores, Managing Counsel of the Public Interest Law Center, asserts the PNP's action in connection with the death of Etchanis are highly suspicious. Pastores argues the family of Etchanis should have full custody of his remains. She says by taking the remains, the police should be charged with obstruction of justice.
Kung meron man dapat kasuhan ng obstruction of justice, it is the PNP. Why? Because the autopsy of the body of Randall Etchanis is scheduled on Wednesday by the hospital and person chosen by the family. And by insisting on keeping the custody of the body, the PNP is the one committing an obstruction of justice.
In the meantime, the paralegal of Philippine Party List Group Anak Pawis gets arrested for alleged obstruction of justice. Paralegal Paolo Colabres was part of a group arranging for the release of Etchanis' remains. Colabres lawyer Maria Sol Taules says the complaint filed against Colabres has no basis and nothing but an act of harassment. Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara has ordered an investigation into the killing of Etchanis. Raya Capulong, ABS-CBN News.